Hello, hello. What up? What's up? I'm Misha, and this is Misha C. Tarot, and I hope you're doing well. Do y'all see that? It says, I wanted to be more than friends. That is my download that I received. The download message that I, well, the song channel song that I kept getting was, it was, what is it? Yeah. Over and over again. I try to tell myself that we could never be more than friends. And all the while inside, they knew it was real. They knew that this was more than a friendship between you two. They knew it. This could be you or this could be somebody else. But I don't want to say that they were denying the connection, but somebody just wasn't sure. They weren't sure. All right, I'm definitely getting like left-handed. Somebody could be left-handed as well. And I'm definitely getting like you guys could have met through a friend, okay? Or through a family member. I'm definitely getting like long night talks. Or you guys could like conversate for a very long period of time, okay? And it could be about all different types of topics. But you guys just love communicating with one another. I'm definitely getting that somebody... Because I feel like for some people, you're still in contact with this person. And then for others, you're not in contact with this person. Somebody wished that they would have pursued you instead of just being friends or labeling it as a friendship. And there was so much more there. So I want to get some hidden truth oracles for the collective that it may resonate with. I'm getting like you guys could have met in the fall. The leaves were falling. The leaves were brown and gold. And I'm just definitely getting like the fall. This could have been before Thanksgiving or before Christmas. Or it actually could have been around that time. I'm just getting like there were feelings that you were getting from this person that you hadn't felt in a long time, or for some of you, you haven't felt from anybody. But they were supposed to be your friend, or they were just supposed to be your friend. God, I thank you. Jesus, I thank you. Angels and ancestors of the Most High, with your white light, please guide and protect us as we go into the tarot, and allow me to channel clear and honest messages for the collective. Okay, now what I have here is, I know I messed everything up. Wow. Somebody could have shied away. Or made some type of distance in between you two. It says, I hope that you can forgive me one day. At the bottom of the deck. We also have here, I wonder if you're happy without me. Yeah, so this could be definitely for two people that are not in communication with each other right now. It says, I wish I could take my words back. Wow, I'm definitely getting somebody could deny what they were feeling. And they knew it was real. You knew it was real. The letter four. Wow. The number four could be significant. Tell me more, Holy Spirit. Clear and honest messages, please. Regarding this situation. It says, I know I was a distraction from your pain. At the bottom of the deck, it says, I love you unconditionally, and I am becoming a better person. So somehow or some way, this person could have helped you become a better person, or you're helping this person become a better person. They know that they were a distraction from your pain or what was going on in your life at this time. I feel like you were the happy or they were the happy at that time, okay? And they're wondering if you're happy without them. I don't know why. Like, something's very emotional. And emotion, when I say emotion, I mean like teary-eyed. Like, somebody could get teary-eyed, all right? That's how I'm feeling. My breathing is heavier. My chest is heavy. Tell me more, Holy Spirit. I know I messed everything up. I feel like somebody wasn't being truthful and honest with the way they were feeling towards you, okay? The Ten of Cups with the Justice card showing itself. Excuse me, the Ten of Pentacles. Clear and honest messages for the collective, Holy Spirit. Over and over again, I try to tell myself that we could never be more than friends. All the while inside, they knew it was real. The way you making it. Oh my goodness, I cannot stand that. When my card's like all the places it could fall, it go right in the damn slit. Okay. Maybe I should put something right there so that don't happen, huh? Clearing honest messages for the collective regarding the messages that I receive, Holy Spirit. We have here, I miss you. Ooh. Did I just say that? It does not say that. It says that nowhere here. We have here, I miss you. What the hell? I know I messed up everything. I wonder if you're happy without me. I wish I could take, but I'm just getting with this I. Somebody is blaming themselves for why you guys' relationship didn't flourish or it didn't grow or it didn't turn into more than just this friendship. I wish I could take back my words. I know I was a distraction from your pain. Clarify. I know I messed everything up, Holy Spirit. Clear and honest messages for the collective, please. Holy Spirit, I thank you. Clearing on this messages for the collective. I know I messed everything up. I'm being told to shuffle. I know I messed everything up. Holy Spirit, clearing on this messages. Oh my gosh, I'm just definitely getting like with all this. Like, somebody gets choked up about you. Somebody could be asking other people, asking this friend or this family member that connected you to, how are you doing or how's life treating you? We have here the Magician card with the Temperance energy. They feel like you were heaven sent and they could have rejected a gift from the Most High. They feel like you were a gift from the Most High that they rejected. All right. And not intentionally, but I think it was more of a fear of, were they good enough for you? Were they worthy? Did they deserve you? It's something about this felt too good to be true. I'm seeing a bow and an arrow, okay, with this Sagittarius energy. But I'm definitely getting that with this wand that he's holding up here. Or this, whatever that is, all right? Somebody's trying to manifest you back on their life. They feel strongly for you with this Four of Wands, the Strength card, the Temperance energy, Leo, Sagittarius, Aries energy, okay? Somebody could definitely be a fire sign here, or you could be. Tell me more about this Magician. I know I messed things up. Somebody's willing, they want to repatch, rekindle. They want to come back into connection with you. I'm just getting like somebody's headed towards you. The letter G could be significant. Tell me more, Holy Spirit. That's the truth. With the Ace of Swords here and the King of Wands at the bottom of the deck, somebody could have jumped the gun on judging the situation. They didn't give it time, or they didn't give themselves time. All right, I'm definitely getting like somebody is too hard on themselves, all right? They question everything. Should I do this? Should I do this? Is it right? Should I say this? Or maybe I shouldn't say that right now. It's too soon. Like, they're just second-guessing everything. And it's like, with you, this person, with this King of Wands here, I'm definitely getting like with, why am I about to cry? I feel like crying. What the fuck? Okay. With this King of Wands here, I'm definitely getting like, this is a boss. This is somebody who always has it figured out. And with you, they just couldn't put their, like they could not put their finger on it with you. It's like, damn, what do I say? What do I do? I'm also getting, should I wear this? Or is this overdressed? Or is this too much? Okay, I'm definitely getting that. Clarify this King of Wands, Ace of Swords, Holy Spirit, please. For the collective, I know I messed everything up. Somebody wants to make something right between you in them. Somebody could be at the gym, okay? Or somebody could be like a gymnast, or they really love like working out, okay? Fruit smoothies and like really focused on their body. Tell me more, Holy Spirit, about this King of Wands. Really focused on their physical health. Somebody could also wear V-necks a lot. Clearing on this messages, Holy Spirit. King of Wands, Ace of Swords. We have here the Death card with the Three of Swords as well as the Nine of Cups. I don't know what this person said. With this Three of Swords here and the Death card, they know they hurt you. They know they hurt you. I'm feeling like they could have intentionally sabotaged the connection, pushed you away. You could be a Scorpio as well as a Gemini. And with this Nine of Cups, they knew they wanted you. They knew they wanted this. The Ten of Cups, the Knight of Cups, the Ten of Cups, the Nine to the Ten. Also with the the Knight of Cups. They loved everything about you, everything about the situation. I'm definitely getting like somebody could also be bisexual as well. This could be a same-sex relationship. Wow. That's deep. I'm just getting like something felt too good to be true. Tell me more, Holy Spirit. I wonder if you're happy without me. Clearing honest messages, please. I wonder if you're happy without me. The Seven of Cups in reverse with the Nine of Pentacles. Okay, so if somebody's wondering if someone's single, they are. They are single. And they're not confused about everything that happened. They understand exactly why you did what you did. Or you could understand exactly why this person did what they did. I don't know why I'm getting this. Like, somebody could see you as a perfect wife or husband or lifetime partner, okay? They've never looked at anyone ever and seen, like, oh my gosh, I could be with this person for the long haul. They felt that strongly with you, okay? Y'all could have actually talked about this. Actually, not necessarily you two being married or in commitment, in a serious commitment like that, but just the conversation in general. I feel like you guys are really deep. I feel like there was no topic that you guys didn't touch on. I'm definitely getting like somebody could live where there's tornadoes or there's a storm or it's storming right now. But yes, this person is single. Tell me more, but I wonder if you're happy without me. Or you could be single. The Knight of Pentacles with the Seven of Cups. In reverse, Holy Spirit. Nine of Pentacles with the Seven of Cups in reverse. It's like a lot of people are confusing, but I definitely feel like you brought... Oh, wow, the Lover's card. With the Eight of Wands. Ooh, and the Ten of Pentacles, y'all. Six of Wands. Baby, this person loves you. They probably haven't said it yet, but everything that their actions was showing you that they loved you. So somebody could have been like, so why the hell did you say those things, or why did you do that? They know they fuck shit up or they mess things up. This was a love of a lifetime. Like I keep saying, this is a gift. This was a gift from the Most High given to somebody. I'm just getting like a juicer. Somebody could like really like, somebody could be vegan or something like that. I don't know. Or pescatarian, all right? I'm just definitely getting that. Okay, with this Ten of Pentacles here and the Knight of Wands. Sex was nowhere near important. Sex could have not, you guys probably haven't even went that far, all right? I'm definitely getting like somebody could have kinky, nappy hair, okay? Or waves or really curly hair. We have here the Hermit and the Page of Swords. This person could also be watching you from afar, even though they haven't communicated this to you. All right, they're trying to check. Like with this Hermit here alone and the Nine of Pentacles here alone, somebody is like wondering if you're still single. Are you still available? Available. Virgo energy, okay. Gemini energy, the Page of Swords. Clarify this Page of Swords, the Hermit. Because I feel like you made this person see something was within their self. You brought something out of this person that had been smothered or that had been pushed down or suppressed, okay? Somebody could also love the water or to be in water. You could be a water sign. Tell me more, Holy Spirit. Page of Swords with the Hermit here. Yes, with the Queen of Pentacles. I'm just definitely getting like somebody telling somebody like, you have so much to offer. There's so much more for you to offer. Somebody could love pets or animals or work like with animals or pets, okay? Somebody's very caring, very nurturing. I don't know, somehow or some way you've motivated this person to do something with their self. Okay, yes, the Ace of Wands here, the Page of Pentacles, they learned something from you. The Star card, it's like you're all they want. They can have dreams about you, okay? Tell me more about this Queen of Pentacles, Holy Spirit, Page of Swords. I'm just definitely getting like this person is checking for you, okay? With the Tower here and the World card. Oh, wow. It's like they knew that they were supposed to take a chance on this love. They knew this. And with this Tower here, Scorpio energy, that Death card with the Three of Swords here, okay? That Scorpio energy, somebody ended something that should have been. Somebody could have tattoos of a bird or tattoos of wings. Or you could be seeing birds a lot, or white birds, or hearing birds. Tell me more. I wish I could take back my words. Yeah, they know they messed everything up, and they wish they could take back their words. Clarify that for me, Holy Spirit. I wish I could take back my words. The Ace of Wands, the Page of Pentacles, and the Star card. It's like a lesson learned. I'm definitely getting like they learned a hard lesson. It's like somebody was trying to avoid something or avoid someone. Avoid the way they felt, suppress the way they feel, dilute it, downplay it, and they know it's so much more. They knew it was so much more. Ooh. I don't know why I'm getting like I would die for an opportunity with you, or I don't know why I want to say that, but I would kill for an opportunity. And I don't think this person means like literally. I just mean like that's how serious they are about you now. Not that they didn't take you for granted then, but they are just so serious about this connection now. They'd wish they'd played their cards right. Tell me more about this Ace of Wands, Holy Spirit. The Two of Swords, Ace of Pentacles. Like, they didn't know. They didn't know. With the World card and the Seven of Swords, they played theyselves. They played theyselves. Somebody said something to hurt somebody. Intentionally, I've been picking up on the letter P for a while now, for like 2 weeks, the letter P. Tell me more about I know I was a distraction from your pain, Holy Spirit. Regarding the collective clearing on this messages. The Six of Wands and the Three of Pentacles. They feel like you two just go together like peas and carrots. Like you just, it just fucking works. They don't know how, they don't know why, but they've been around so many different people or they've been with different people and they've never connected on the level that you two have. You're so wise, okay? You're so wise. And they feel like they've learned a lot from you just in this short time of you two getting to know each other or just within these few months, okay? Somebody could also be an Aries as well. I feel like this person wants to rekindle this friendship in hopes that it will grow into something so much more. Tell me about I love you unconditionally, because I don't feel like this person has verbalized this to you, because I feel like they're loving you. They love you. And they're in hopes that they'll soon fall in love with you. But they love you. Tell me more, Holy Spirit, with that lover's card here. I try to tell myself that I'm being guided to pull. Yes, with the Queen of Cups at the bottom of the deck and the Eight of Cups with the Six of Pentacles, somebody is like shooting their own self in the damn foot. Like, how the hell did I let her get away? How the hell did I let him get away? I paused that at 19:19, 10:10 on the clock. Clarify, give me some clarification for the collective, Holy Spirit. I know I messed things up. I wonder if you're happy without me. I wish I could take back my words. I know I was a distraction from your pain. Excuse me. I love you unconditionally. Clear and honest messages for the collective, please. Clear and honest messages. We have here ascending, transcending obstacles, learning, expansion, new phase, preparing for union. I can't make it up. Preparing for a union, okay? At the bottom of the deck, we have engagement ring. Okay, I feel like this time, it's for real. Tell me how you feel. It's for real. Tell me how you feel for real. Like, don't play with it now. Don't play with it, all right? Engagement, partnership, commitment, eternity. Union. Once again, two cards saying union. One more, Holy Spirit, for the collective. Somebody's name could be Diamond. Tell me more, Holy Spirit. Okay, that's a lot. I'm going to leave that right here. Well, we have here meeting and conversing, savoring the moment, feeling uplifted and friendship. I like you. I do. With kiss, I want to be your friend. Go shopping in Ubbins. I like you. I do. He said, can you fit me in your plans? Somebody's trying to make plans with you at this time. Or there'll be, I feel like if you haven't spoken with this person, they're definitely coming in to communicate with you, okay? I don't know why I'm going to name this reading, okay? We also have here Hand of Cards, Separation, and the Snake. Yeah, I'm definitely getting like this person. Ooh. That could have still been attached to somebody. All right, another person, another woman, or another man. This other person is very malicious. Very competitive. Okay, very competitive. And this person could have felt like they needed to compete with you, but you weren't nothing but this person's friend. You guys were just friends, all right? And somebody feel like they fucked up. They feel like they got dealt the shitty hand, or they played the hand real shitty with this. Like I said that earlier about somebody, did I? Yeah, I said that earlier about somebody feeling like they didn't play their cards right, okay? We have here a Hand of Cards, a Snake, as well as Separation, Sadness, Missing You, Thinking of You, Yearning, and Unsure of the Future. So somebody wants to know, is there still a chance that they've cut off the distraction, all right? Or they cut off this person that does not serve their highest good, okay? Yeah, we have here Grim Reaper. The relationship is over. So you're all this person wants. So you're all they're focused on at this time, okay? There's no more wearing a mask. They're going to completely reveal themselves to you fully. There's no more hiding. There's no more none of that. They want to know what's up. What that shit do or what it don't do. How you doing? Where you been? Like, what's up? Clearing out this message for the collective. I'm going to go ahead and pull some soulmate oracles, and I'm going to leave you guys with that. Holy Spirit, please give me clear and honest. I'm thirsty. Please give me clear and honest messages for the collective. I'm hearing it, girl. I like you. I do. Wanna be a friend, go shopping in a bed. I like you. I do. Clear and honest messages for the collective, please, Holy Spirit. Ascending, engagement ring, coffee cup. I like you. We have here, your life does not get better by chance. It gets better by change. I keep getting that, like something with a bird or a birds, okay? A bird just speaking to you at this time. Or you could be like surrounded by a lot of birds, or there could be like this one bird that keeps coming by you or keeps coming near your house or keeps coming near your home. Yo, story time. Every day, my dog Oreo rests her soul. I fucking love that dog, and I ain't got a dog since. I loved that dog, okay? She was a damn human. She wasn't a dog. Like, the way she was. And it was this squirrel that would come visit her every morning. I'm talking about every day. Every day. I would let, she would be outside, and I'd look out the window, and there go the squirrel running on the line of the fence. I'm talking about back and forth. Back and forth, and Oreo would just chase the squirrel back and forth, back every morning, same time, every day. All right, so I'm definitely getting like there could be an animal, a spirit animal that is coming to visit you like every day. I feel like there's a message that this animal is trying to send to you. All right, it says, let things come and go, stay calm, don't let anything disturb your peace, and carry on. All right. So I'm definitely getting like somebody is single, or you and this person is single, okay? There's nothing but space and opportunity between you two. Tell me more, Holy Spirit, clearing on this messages. It says, try to be a rainbow in someone else's cloud. At the bottom of the deck, it says, all you need is to believe in yourself. Clearing on this messages for the collective. I'm definitely getting that as well, like, something that this person said or was doing was allowing this person to keep their head above water and to not drown in whatever it is that was consuming them. It's like somebody was an outlet or a way out. Or once again, we have all you need to do is to believe in yourself. You could have gave this person some type of encouragement. Like, you know how we say liquor courage? Like, there's some type of encouragement that you gave this person that they really and honestly truly needed, okay? The color green could be very significant. Definitely get them, like, heart chakra as well. Green could be somebody's favorite color. It says the reason it hurts so much to separate is because your souls are connected. The reason it hurt so much to separate is because your souls are connected. It says you're moving into a steady and reliable path. I love you guys. I'm sending you the 2525 on the clock, 7-7. I'm sending you the utmost love and respect, peace, healing, joy, prosperity, abundance, love, and hella that shit.